The following is an unpaid political announcement.
Hello, fellow Americans. This here is Roy D. Mercer. Once again, speaking to y'all as write-in candidate and Pop Knot Party nominee for president of these here United States. And in keeping with my no pussyfooting policy, I'd like to get on down to brass tacks. That is to say, it's high time I rolled up my sleeves and let the fur start to fly. As I guarantee you, in spite of what a bunch of candy-assed, vest-wearing, bottled water-sipping political analysts tell me, this ain't just a two-man race. No, sir. This is going to be a Katie bar the door, knock-down, drag-out, ring-tail battle royal. Because when I done got my hackles up when they didn't invite me to one of them 3,000 debates, I got a little PO'd. Not only does it make them look like a bunch of Freddy Pants panty waist, but hell's bells, let's be honest. Not having me in the debates is like making up a batch of party mix and leaving out the goobers. Of course, I wasn't all that upset anyways. Well, bull butter. Let's face it, the only debating I know anything about is debating my hook and putting on a fresh cricket. And besides, most of them is worthless anyhow. If it was up to me, we'd just have a 2 out of 3 arm wrestling contest and be done with it. Strip down to your skivvies so we can tell if Romney's cheating and wearing his magic underwear. And since that ain't likely to happen, let me share with y'all some more no-nonsense attitudes about how we need to run this country. First, there's welfare. I believe there's 4 simple words that'll take care of the whole gall-dang thing, and that is, get off your ass. Second, the youth of America. Now, I know there's a lot of y'all out there that thinks most of them little honyocks is a lost cause. All they can see is from the outside. Whatever is not pierced or shaved is tattooed. But I tell you, my kids has made me think different. They've been a-telling me that they is with it, and they know where it's at. And I tell you, I've been watching some of that MTV, and with some of them skimpy costumes them gals is a-wearing, no wonder they know where it's at. Hell, they can see it. Third, I don't believe there ought to be allowed to sell anything on TV that clings to my natural body contours. Fourth, in no way, shape, or form would I ever condone any policy that allows our government to ever do business with any of them crazy numbnuts out in the world. You know, like Somali pirates, Japanese whalers, or Jerry Jones. Fifth, if elected, I want to make it a $500 fine if you's a driving a car and got anything in your hands other than a slushie or a Slim Jim. I'm telling you that these cellular phones is more of a traffic hazard than Grandma after she takes her morning Xanax. And six, the war on drugs. And if any of y'all have ever seen one of them Flamin' Lips concerts, you know we already lost it. And finally, seventh, free lifetime fishing license for anybody named Roy Mercer. I just threw that in to see if y'all was paying attention. But I'm serious about the rest of it. Serious as a yeast infection in Charlie Sheen's house, by God. So them's just a few of the many other things that separate me from my other so-called opponents. So when it comes time in November to get in that little booth and do your thing, no, not what you're thinking, Coach Petrino, vote for a real American. Vote for me, Roy D. Mercer. That's Roy Damn Mercer for president. Well, I still promise y'all, vote for me or I'll whoop your ass.
Paid for by Smitty's Gun Closet and Craft Barn. Ask about our semi-automatic glue guns.